Hi, this is Carrie with Learn DaVinci Resolve, and today we are going to build a particle effect that's going to look like fog. You'll be able to use this in all kinds of different projects. It's one of my favorite kind of things to do with special effects, whether you're doing titles or you just want to kind of add a fog effect into something. It's going to be kind of fun. It's probably going to be a fairly long tutorial today, so kind of bear with me. There's a bunch of little steps. There's a lot of tweaking to make things look right, but I'm trying to explain it as we go so you understand what we're going to accomplish. And I'm going to show you right now what this is going to look like. So that's the effect we're going to achieve. So stay right there. We'll be right back. So to get started, we need a fusion composition first. If you're on Resolve 15, you're going to go to Generators, and you'll find it on 16. It's under Effects, and we're just going to grab a fusion composition here, and we'll make it like 10 seconds long. And right there. All right, now we're going to go into Fusion, and we're actually not going to start off with creating the fog effect. We're going to create the fog particles first. So on here, I'm going to do shift space. I'm going to add a fast noise node, and I'm going to add a saver node. And you'll see how all this stuff comes together in just a moment. On fast noise, we're going to start on the image frame or the image panel here, and I'm going to turn off auto resolution. I don't want these particles to be the size of the screen. I want them to be fairly small. So I'm going to set my size of these images to 200, 200. And I'm going to go back to my noise panel. I'm going to, let's actually bring this up so we can kind of see what's happening as we go. I'm going to take the detail and change it to 5 so we have more detail. And I'm going to set the seethe to 0.1. Okay, now we're getting somewhere here. And let's also go onto the color page. We'll make this a gradient and we'll change it to a radial. And on the first stop here, I want this to be kind of a middle gray. And the end, I'm going to make that black. And we're going to center this up a little bit. So I'm going to grab this left handle over here and bring it into the middle, and I'll bring the right handle and bring it in about a third of the way maybe. So that's kind of what our smoke particles are going to look like. But we also need this to be transparent. So I'm going to go over to the alpha channel and slide all that down. So now it kind of looks like a fog particle. Let's go with that. Now the saver is going to allow us to save these, this whole animation thread out as individual frames. They're going to be EXR files. And then we'll use those to feed the particle system instead of having it create them. So it should be a little easier on the system. So I've got my saver node here. And I'm going to hit browse. I'll go to my desktop and I'll create a new folder called noise, and I'll just name it fast fog, and these are going to be open EXR files. There's not too many choices here, and I'm going to hit save. Now I need to save these off, so I'm going to go up to the fusion tab and say render all savers, and it should create all the different frames. There we go. 239 took 3.19 seconds. Not too shabby. So next, we can go in and start creating our fog effect. So I'm actually going to get rid of these, and we're going to create a really basic 3D scene. So let's just do a text 3D, and we'll just call it foggy, and have that up on the screen here. We'll just extrude that a little bit, so we have something to work with. And with any 3D scene, we need to have a merge 3D and a render node, render, and then that can go into our media out. Okay, so now we have kind of our scene going on here. I'll just kind of center this up on here. There we go. All right, next we need to start adding our particle system. So particles are actually right here on the screen, on this toolbar. So I'm just going to click on one and create a particle emitter. And then we need a P render node. And that's going to be the next one here. Now, when we're working with particles, we need to determine whether we want this to be a 2D scene or a 3D scene. And for our purposes here, we want this to be a 3D scene so we can add some depth to it. So in the node editor, we're going to make sure we select the P render node. And in the inspector, we're going to set the output mode to 3D. So if this is set on 2D, make sure you put that on 3D. And I'm going to put that up on screen 2 here so we can see that. So now we have this, the 3D scene. And, you know, we could go to our single screen. There's really not much to see yet, but we do have our little particles going on here. And we'll go to our P emitter. So the particle emitter is where the particles come from. So we need to adjust this for whatever type of situation we want it to be. So if we look at kind of the options here, this is our emitter options, the number of particles, the amount it's going to vary, how long they're going to last, and the lifespan variance. So if we have them set to 100, some will be a little less, some will be a little more. If we increase the variance, we can choose colors and the position variance. There's also other tools down here for velocity, rotation, and spin, and we'll get to those some other time. Then we have our style, and this is the style of the emitter itself. So in the style, we're going to change this to a blob. So you can see these are kind of big, puffy looking circles, and it's often good to start with blobs because they're not very, well, they're not as intensive as other particles, and it will kind of help us get things rolling, so to speak. So if we like go to the beginning here, where we are, we're at the end, and we can actually play this, and we can see kind of what's going on here, which is not much of anything, is it? So we definitely have some work to do on here because there's no motion. So we're going to go back to our P emitter. And we'll go to the first tab there. And we need to set the velocity. And let's set the velocity to like 0.2. So now we can, I'm going to zoom out here so we can kind of see what's going on. So now it has a direction that it's going. So we can change the direction that it's going to go to. And, you know, up, down, left to right, or straight up, whatever we want to do. And we're going to set the velocity to, or the velocity angle to 180. Now it's going the opposite direction. Okay, see that? Now the particles start at the beginning and they'll run until the end. So if you want them to already be there when it starts, that's going to be another setting that we'll get to in a different point. But for right now, we're just going to build it kind of one step at a time here. Now, if we take a close look at this, they're all moving at the same rate. And that's definitely not something we want. It doesn't look natural at all. Now, there could be a reason for doing that, depending on the effect that you're trying to go for. But with something like smoke or fog, that's definitely not going to work right. So we need to add some variance to the velocity. So let's set the velocity variance to 0.1. All right, now let's take a look at it. So you can see some are moving faster than others, but and there's just a little mix to it. which is nice. So right now it's pumping out a lot of these particles, so way too many for our needs. So I'm going to change the emitter number to 0.3. Now let's see what we've got here. Okay, starting to look a little bit better. Now we have kind of a blob starting about every 3 frames. Of course, that doesn't sound like a big number, but it's always easy to change, and we kind of want to build up to things. Now, I did set this for 10 seconds, so that's 240 frames. And right now, the lifespan is set to 100. And if we set, let's try setting this to 50. Oh, oops, I set it to 500. If we set it to 50, they're only going to last half of the time. But we do want them to last pretty much the whole scene. So I'm going to go ahead and bump that back up to 100 so that they're going to continue to fill the scene. So sometimes you want to change the shape of the P emitter. If you're doing something like a firework or something that actually starts at a point, then you need that to be a small point. If you're doing rain, sleet, snow, hail, fog, smoke, haze, you don't want it to be a point that it's coming from. You want it to be a much bigger angle. So we're going to go to our region tab over here, and we're going to change the sphere to a cube. And now we can adjust the size of that. So I'm going to set my height. Now you can see it's going to be kind of coming out from different sides of it. There we go. Let's move this over here. And right now they're still coming from a very narrow spot. And it'd be fine if this was kind of a 2D or we just wanted in front of it, but we kind of want to fill the scene. We're going to have fog in front and back of our object. So we definitely want a little more depth to it. So now you can see what I've got going here is they're coming from this whole cube. So for right now, we'll leave this here until we get the rest of our objects, our text down there, all put together with this, and then we can always adjust things. But now we're going to bring in the fog that we created with the fast emitter. So I've got a bin here called fog. I'm just going to go here and go import media, and I'm going to go to the first file there and select open. And now I can drag this down here. I'm going to change the name on this by hitting F2. I'm going to change this to fog EXR so I know what that media in was. And on the P emitter, we need to go to our style, and we're going to change this to a bitmap. And when we do that, this new arrow comes up on the emitter that's going to allow us to connect our fog to the emitter. Hope this is making sense so far. We're kind of getting there, but now look at the difference in the little particles. They actually look like the little puffs of smoke that we created before. So I'm going to go back to the dual settings here. Let's go ahead and connect our prender to our merge node. And I'm going to go to our media out. So this is what we've got so far. Kind of little puffers going on. It's not really the most interesting looking thing yet, but we're getting there. And okay, we got our fog emitter here. Let's look at our lineup. Okay, that's looking good. Okay, so everything's kind of centered around that cube, which is what we want. We want stuff in front and behind. So we're kind of making some progress there. So let's go back to our P emitter, because obviously these little puffies aren't doing exactly what we want yet. We'll get there though. We'll definitely get there. And we want to make sure we're on the style tab. And we're going to go to size controls, and we're going to set our size to 0.5. And we're going to change our size variance to 0.05. So I'm going to add 0.05 there. So you see it's kind of starting to look like something, right? It's definitely a little more. Now, I'm running this on a 2016 5K iMac, 32 gigs of RAM, and all of a sudden, as soon as I did that, notice how much slower it's rendering here. This stuff does take up some processing power. So if it's kind of laggy on your machine, yeah, it's probably going to be laggy. There's not much you can do about it. In another video, we'll probably talk about how to optimize things and see if we can make it a little smoother for it to work with, because there are a couple tricks that can work. Now, we also want to give, I said we don't want it to start all the way on the right and have nothing there. We want fog to be in the scene. So I'm going to go to my pre-render, and we'll go to pre-generate frames. And I probably want this to be, well, let's play this and see where we get, where we kind of want it to be. It's probably going to be around the halfway point, right? So probably right in the, looks like about, let's call it 115. So I'm going to pre-generate 115 frames. But now also by doing that, what I might end up with is running out at the end. And I don't want that to happen either. So I'm just going to stop this. So we can see, nope, it's all good. We're looking good so far. We're making some progress here. Okay, so now to make it a little more realistic, we're going to make sure we're on our renderer 3D node. We're going to change the renderer type to OpenGL renderer. And in here, we're going to go to sorted accurate. That's going to give it a little bit more natural look to it. I'm kind of liking that so far. And we could add some coloring to it if we wanted to, but for right now, I think we'll just kind of stick with this. And let's give it a little play here. It's still not looking quite right, right? So we'll go to our P emitter again, and we'll go to our controls node, and we probably need to give it a little bit of spin. So let's give some Z variance, like 0.5. So now stuff is moving along a little bit better. Kind of liking that so far. If we increase that, you will get even more spin out of it, but that's way too much. We just need just a little bit of spin to make it look right. And there we have kind of a cool fog effect. Let's go ahead and go to our edit page. Of course, you can keep adjusting this and adjusting this. It kind of looks like little puffy clouds right now. Probably not exactly what we want, but you can see how the smoke is moving in. The smoke looks very natural. But let's go ahead and try and play around with it just a little bit more. And we'll probably play with the size. If we bring it down more. But notice it's only letting us go to 0.5. Now what if I go to 1? All right, so sometimes a slider will only let you go so far, and you kind of have to push it to do something. So often you can just type in a number that's going to increase the value that you're allowed to put into there. So let's go ahead and give this a play. And that's looking quite a bit bigger. I think we can really kind of fine tune this by adjusting the size of our P emitter. So let's go ahead. I think the width is fine. Let's give it some more height. Again, we're already maxed out on our height. So let's make this a 2. Now it's going to make sure that it's outside of the frame, which I think is really going to make this effect work. All right. Things are starting to really come together with our fog, but I'm not keen on how the lifespan variance is. Let's go ahead and go back to here, and we'll change our lifespan variance, or we'll increase our lifespan to more than what our frames are, right? We had it set at 100, but we actually have 240 frames, and we're starting late. So we want to make sure that we have good coverage. So I'm just going to call it 350. Now, this should be a little bit more normal. It's still kind of puffing in there, which I'm not too keen on. So I'm going to pull the emitter a little further away so they're not starting right on top of it. Okay, that's looking pretty good. I'm going to slow down the fog a bit so it just kind of moves in like that. Let's try pulling it back a little further. There we go. Now we have a much more natural looking fog effect. Let's go ahead and let this render so we can play it back in full time. Okay, now that it's rendered, but remember now we moved that emitter over. So now it's not starting where we want. So we're going to have to increase our pre-render time again. And once it's going, there isn't a lot of movement. So it's not like there's a lot of like extra wind or something. So we're going to improve that as well. So we're going to go back into our fog here and let's see where we need to be. So we'll make sure we select our pre-render frame. And right now we're set for 115 frames, but it's not quite enough. So let's pre-generate maybe 150 frames. So now let's go to the beginning. It's not quite enough. We'll call it 200 frames. We really just want it to be there. And we'll go to the end here. We'll make sure everything's good there. So now we have fog throughout the whole scene, but we need to add some turbulence to it to add a little random chaosness. So with the P emitter selected, I'm going to go shift space and I'm going to type P turbulence. All right. And we'll set some options in here. So let's set our density to 75 and let's see what we get here. Okay, that's definitely a little bit better. We got a little bit of movement going on, so we can try playing with the strengths, seeing what we kind of get there. All right. So we're getting a little more movement around and front and back strengths going on. So kind of like that. The higher the density, the kind of the less chaotic it will be. But we'll still want some turbulence, so it just looks a little bit more natural. And let's go ahead and let's add a spotlight. I'll put that connected to the merge 3D and I'll pull this guy out here and we need to make sure we turn on our 3D options for lighting and shadows. So we want to go to our renderer 3D, go to our lighting, and we're going to enable lighting. That way we can have some light effect going on in here. I'm going to take my spotlight and let's just warm up that light just a tad. So we're getting some light effect going through the fog onto the letters. Now this will probably take a little bit longer to render than without the lighting effect because that's adding a whole lot more processing to it, but it's still going pretty good. On Resolve 15, this will probably take quite a bit longer, which is why I'm doing this on 16, so I can actually get through this tutorial in a fairly short amount of time. So it's definitely much better on 16 with the right hardware. I don't recommend using 16 for production use, although all my videos lately have been using 16 and it's been working quite well for me. So now watch the movement in here. That's what I really want you to pay attention to. So we have this turbulence going on, and now we have, we have a very, very realistic fog effect going on. So that's it. You've created your first particle effect. I hope you enjoyed that. Like I said, particles are a super powerful feature within Resolve, because you can do everything from a fog effect to fire and rain, snow, leaves blowing, birds. I mean, you can create all kinds of effects with the particle system, and this is just barely scratching the surface on some of the settings. But using the fog is going to get you started with something that you can probably use over and over and over again. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Be sure and like the video. Give me a big thumbs up on there if you'd like. Smash down on that subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever we have new videos come out. And for the people that asked, yes, there is a Patreon page now. Patreon.com/KERRYG, Kerry G, that's me. Hit it up over at Patreon. I'll do some special stuff for any of you Patreon supporters out there. Really appreciate you guys asking for that, so I put that together for you. As always, thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.